congratulations. Thank you. Regular season champions. What did you tell the team after the game?
I told them I was proud of them. I am. Every single game all season long has been a battle. The conference is very balanced, as you can see, in scores any given night. But I thought just overall, we've persevered, we've persisted, we've gotten better every single game, and we've closed out a lot of close games. So I was just really proud of the way, despite a few turnovers late and it becoming a pretty close game, we held our composure, and to be able to win conference in the GLIAC is very, very tough. So they accomplished a great feat.
Yeah, you had a very tough opponent again for the second time today in Wisconsin Parkside. What did you do to overcome the barrier of how good they are?
I think our defensive urgency was good. We played man-to-man today, went a little bit less zone, and I thought overall our communication was really good. But on the offensive end of the floor, because they were scoring it and they were making tough shots and attacking hard, we needed to be aggressive and get the ball inside. And I thought Jordan was ultra aggressive. When she got the ball, she was posting up hard, creating for us. So that was huge, I think, in just getting our offense, even getting other people open with her posting up hard. So I thought she did a good job. And everyone who came in, they gave us good minutes. Clara came in and got a quick bucket and defended hard. So I thought overall, just a great team win. We needed everybody. We needed every possession. So.
Yeah, looking forward at the GLIAC tournament now. You don't have too much time off before that starts. What do you have to do to get prepared?
Yeah, resting up is going to be a big key. Giving them a couple days. We do have some players playing quite a bit of minutes. So resting up, mentally preparing. We won't know who we play until after Tuesday. So until then, it's just focusing on us, a little bit of skill development, watching the film from our game, learning from this game, as we have with every game that we played. But just making little tweaks, little adjustments, if we can grow every single day, that'll put us in a great position.
Well, you talked a little bit about Jordan's effort, but two straight double-doubles for her. What is it that makes her so difficult to guard inside?
Yeah, it does not surprise me one bit that she had back-to-back double-doubles. I think she can continue to do that. I think it's just her mindset. She is so aggressive. And when she gets the ball, she's patient on the initial catch, and then she makes the pay no matter what you do. If they cut her off, she goes into her counter. If not, she'll go right to the rim. She had some good kickouts from there as well. And the same thing is on the boards. She's just aggressively pursuing the ball. So I think overall, her being able to get a double-double is just that aggressive mindset.
Wisconsin Parkside did everything they could to get back to a tie game at the end, but you're able to pull it off anyway. Kind of talk about the last couple minutes of the game and how you were able to hold on.
Yeah, the last couple minutes, it was a bit frustrating because we quit running our offense. And what we were doing well, setting the ball screen and letting our post players post up and keeping the ball moving and screening and cutting, we got 10 feet off the three-point line, 20 feet off the three-point line, held the ball, and then we had really long passes that led to turnovers. Honestly, that's probably on me. I should have called timeout and said, just run our offense, continue to be aggressive, because they were pressuring and denying passing lanes. It was tough. That was tough. But for us to turn it over and see them come back when we were up 10 late there, and to still stay composed, get the stop when we needed it, rely on our defense, and for Ellie to make those free throws, that's huge for us. It's huge. Any close game we can be in, the experience that we get is so critical moving into a postseason where, again, every possession is going to matter, and there's going to be close games like that.
I know you're focused on game by game until the end of the season, and you lose that last game or you win that last game. But can you reflect a little bit on the culture? That's now 17 times that Tech women's basketball has been at the top of the GLIAC.
Yeah, it's hard to even describe in words how humbling and amazing it is to be a part of this program. And with just the legacy, with the history, the tradition of Michigan Tech women's basketball, it's just astounding that year in, year out, to have the 17th GLIAC championship. Like I said, in a really tough conference where we have national contenders year in and year out. it makes me just so proud of this team because I know they've worked so hard for it. If you look back at our past 2 years and all the injuries we've went through, and we were able to win the North 2 years ago, but last year we definitely struggled. But even that team and those players and those seniors were so critical in building us up to this point this year and to building that culture. To have a year like that and to still stick together and keep our vision and have the offseason that we did to put us in this position, that it is. It's that tradition, and it's all the Huskies that have come before us, the coaches, the players, that have just really built this culture into what it is. And we're very grateful that we get to just continue on that legacy.
How much of your motivation moving forward into the postseason comes from wanting to do well for your two seniors that lead this team?
I think that is huge right now. Tonight you saw that Cassidy and Bailey, we wanted to play for them. We want them to have as many games as possible to finish out their careers. And they love each other. They're great teammates, they're great people, and we're gonna do everything that we possibly can to keep their season going as long as we can.